Toyota Highlander Hybrid's new technology enhances hybrid efficiency. Toyota is pushing hard in the hybrid game. So how are they going to make it better? The new fourth generation Highlander Hybrid tells us how. In this report, friends, I'm going to talk about these things and also about Toyota's bZ4X electric SUV and Toyota Europe CEO outlining sales ambitions for bZ4X electric SUV. Toyota expects Subaru all-wheel drive technology to help to boost its EV sales. Welcome back, dear friends. This is Armin Haryan from TorqueNews.com. If you are here first time, please subscribe to our channel for daily electric vehicle impartial news and ring the bell so you don't miss my next coverage. And also give us thumbs up for this video. Please like it and share in social media. Tweet it out if you find it helpful and useful. So Peter Nielsen from Torque News Toyota reporting team writes that the Toyota Hybrid System, or THS for short, is the basis for all other hybrid powertrains on the market. With all the fuss about going electric vehicle, going EV, Toyota is still holding firm to its beloved technology, hybrid technology. What is it about hybrid vehicles causing the world's largest car manufacturer to continue making them, and how are they making them better? So Peter says, I found out with the new 2022 Toyota Highlander Hybrid and other models like Venza, some neat adjustments lead to greater fuel efficiency. So we're going to take a look at that in this report. And he says, in this report, I want to touch on one of the many improvements Toyota made to the hybrid platforms to make them even better. So how Toyota is making its hybrid platforms better? One of the things that Peter talks about is variable cooling system for Toyota Hybrid. Electric water pumps or electric thermostats are not new technology. I mean, electric water pumps and electric thermostats are not new technology. Toyota is now using both of these units and a fully variable oil pump to enhance engine efficiency. Controlling engine operating temperature is critical to fuel efficiency. A cold engine uses more gasoline to get it warm and into its ideal stoichiometric burn ratio. By electrically controlling coolant flow speeds and exactly when the thermostat needs to open, we can get up to optimal engine temperature sooner. So what Toyota is trying to do is to make sure in most efficient ways to make engine temperature warmer sooner. Then once at operating temperature, we want to give optimal cooling to the engine. Excessive heat will break down oil faster, so controlling how we cool and how much will allow the engine oil to live a longer life. The conclusion here is that Toyota is not using anything new, but is unique because they are now using existing technology to make its hybrid vehicles more efficient. Toyota is claiming 36 miles per gallon on this large SUV, the Highlander Hybrid. That is very impressive in my opinion, right? What do you think, friends? So efficiency is more than miles per gallon. It is increased engine oil life, decreased engine wear, and overall reduced need for maintenance. Toyota will keep pushing new boundaries for fuel efficiency as time goes on. Peter says, my question to them is, will we see the bZ4X become real, or is this another pipe dream? But I have an update on that too. Speaking of bZ4X, Toyota Europe CEO outlines sales ambitions for bZ4X electric SUV, and the automaker expects Subaru's all-wheel drive technology to help to boost its electric vehicle sales. So, like I just mentioned above, Toyota has been a pioneer in hybrid vehicles, making good technologies, using good technologies, and also starting with the Prius and continuing with the nearly all hybrid lineup in Europe. But the automaker will join the full electric ranks starting in the first half of 2022 with the bZ4X compact electric SUV. The bZ4X was shown as a concept at the 2021 Shanghai Auto Show in April. Beyond Zero, that's what BZ stands. Beyond Zero will be an electric-only sub-brand with 7 BZ models expected to be launched by 2025. The letters BZ stand for Beyond Zero, highlighting Toyota's ambitions to have a net positive impact on the environment. The compact SUV will be built on a dedicated EV platform called eTinga, E-T-N-G-A, and at least initially will be imported into Europe from Japan. In an interview with Automobile News Europe, Toyota Europe CEO Matthew Harrison said bZ4X will probably be a low-volume model at first. That is largely because the Toyota RAV4 compact SUV with its conventional or plug-in hybrid drivetrain will help the brand meet the European Union emission standards in the coming years. I personally think that bZ4X, because it resembles the RAV4, will be a successful car. So we're going to look at that, and you know, Torque News of course will bring it to you as sales come out. So Harrison said it was too early to give a volume projection for the bZ4X for 2023, its first full year of sales, because we haven't really given pricing to the markets and validated the volume distribution. He says, I think it's safe to say that we still expect the RAV4 in hybrid and plug-in form to be the dominant model in this segment through to 2025, when the next round of emissions cuts are due, Harrison said. The RAV4 was fifth in the compact crossover SUV segment with 91,014 sales in Europe, according to Giotto Dynamics market researchers. It was just behind another Toyota model, the slightly smaller cup-styled CHR crossover with 101,910 units. The Volkswagen Tiguan led the segment with 136,616 sales in Europe. Full electric entrants in the segment currently include the Volkswagen ID.4, Tesla Model Y, and IONIQ 5. Renault is among automakers planning to introduce a full electric compact SUV in the next few years. The bZ4X was jointly developed with Subaru, which is 20% owned by Toyota. It leverages Subaru's all-wheel drive technology to offer what Toyota claims is best-in-class all-wheel drive capability. Subaru has said it will launch its own version of the car within the next 5 years. Now keep in mind that Toyota plans to do it next year. It is technology not Toyota's first electric vehicle for Europe. The Mirai sedan uses hydrogen fuel cells to generate power to drive an electric motor. Toyota has long been a proponent of hydrogen power, even as other automakers focused on battery electric drivetrains. Beyond 2025, Toyota will consider building full electric vehicles in Europe, Harrison said, without giving details. Toyota expects that half of its sales in Europe by 2030 will be zero-emission vehicles, meaning about 700,000 to 750,000 vehicles in the region, which includes Russia, Turkey, and former Soviet Union countries. We have a strategy that says we build where we sell, and certainly that volume of sales would necessitate local production, he said. We will bring some zero-emission vehicles into the lineup prior to 2025, but not at the volume that it makes sense to initially produce locally, he said. We're expecting to see further acceleration from 2025 to 2030. This is when we'll really see the more dramatic shift in terms of fuel electrification, he said. So this means that if you are looking for Toyota electric vehicles, look between 2025 to 2030 for further acceleration to electrification. Toyota has 6 assembly plants in its Europe region, in the Czech Republic, France, Portugal, Russia, and the United Kingdom. About 70% of sales in the region are built there, Toyota said. Friends, let me know your thoughts on all these developments. The Highlander hybrid using a new existing technology to enhance its hybrid efficiency, and bZ4X and Toyota's electric plans. This is Armin Harayan from TorqueNews.com. Please subscribe to our channel for daily electric vehicle Toyota impartial news, and let us know your thoughts, please, and share this in social media, and ring the bell so you don't miss my next coverage. Please also like this video if you found it helpful. I would greatly appreciate it. And also, Torque News is looking for more electric vehicle reporters, paid software positions. If anyone is interested, please contact me, send me a sample of your work, and we'll take it from there. Everybody, have a great day. God bless you. You have a peaceful rest of the day. Peace be with all of you, and I'm so going to see you in our next report. See you soon. Have a great day.